Well, very clearly, there has been a focus to ensure that agriculture gets a boost post this budget. But as you'll observe, it's not something we did in a hurry. We used the first year in office to ensure that urea, seeds, all the basic necessities that go into agriculture are provided for the farmers at a fair price. So it's for the first time we've had 3.5 years with not a single agitation for shortage of fertilizer. And what did we do? We did a root cause analysis, figured out that fertilizer, instead of going to the farmer, is being sold to chemical factories because it's a subsidized product, and that chemical value in that fertilizer is worth far more than the value of the price at which fertilizer is available. We coated it with neem and ensured that it's no more good to divert to chemical factories. And the country has no problem of fertilizers in the last 3.5 years. That in 10 years, if you are going to have an average inflation of 8-8.5%, in any case, you are 120% in terms of growth. But it's all inflationary, nothing real. So to my mind, our 5% increase is far more valuable for the farmer, especially since inflation during our tenure has hovered around 2%, 3%. The last quarter is probably the highest we've had in the last 3 years. Just one quarter. But so effectively, we are giving the farmers an increase. So it's not a notional increase that matters. It's the effective increase. So I think farmers has been a focus area. Now that we've got the farmers empowered with all these things, credit, seeds, fertilizer, we have now brought a statutory provision that 50% increase on the investment, on the money spent to honest production. It's going to be a guaranteed situation, and rabi crops are already getting that. Kharif crops will start getting it from this year. I think this is going to really empower the farmer. We are also looking at how we can strengthen the procurement processes. So agrarian rural distress, as you said, is certainly very high on the agenda of this budget and this government. About